Welcome once again to another episode of Nigerly on my YouTube channel, where I talk about things that matter to me the most about Nigeria, in the hope that it matters to you guys as well. My name is Olisa, and today what matters to me the most about Nigeria is Olumintin's video, Nawti. And this video has been on for like 3 weeks now, but I got a request from someone to review it, and I thought, why not? It's a very nice song, a very nice video, I thought I should talk about it a little bit. Hope you guys enjoy. Video of the song is crazy on so many levels. Like I have started on quality wise, concept, girls, everything about this video is crazy. Before watching the music video and doing the review, I started to watch his interview on YouTube. I think it was interviewed by some guy. So the question that they asked me was like, why were they not a lot of Nigerian girls in this video? Well, I'm all for representing our own and everything, but I want to ask one question before I even go into the matter of Nigerian girls, whether Nigerian girls or not in the video. Was the video not good enough? Were the girls they not classy enough? Didn't you like the concept? Didn't you like the quality of the video? That being said, according to Olumintin, there were at least 4 Nigerian girls in the video. Not full Nigerians. Some of them were American born and some of them were half Nigerians. Take for example the girl that did the video justice for me. The girl that was wearing pink with the green shirt, which was whining. Not as much as Natalie Trani. Sorry, none was supposed to be the girl in the spotlight. The girl in the pink pack stole the show without even trying to. Let's show the video again in slow-mo because everything looks good in slow motion. I think I said enough good things about the video. First of all, am I supposed to believe that that girl that was blowing that clarinet or flute or whatever, or oboe or whatever it's called, in that water, am I supposed to believe that she got up that morning, put on those things she wore, then jumped in the water to play the flute? Wouldn't it have been more comfortable if she was using a rubber flute on the water or she was actually playing on land? In that kind of scenario, I was expecting that maybe she should have worn a billowing gown, you get, so that when she jumped, maybe it should have been more like a mistake or an accident when she jumped in the water, then the water on the dress that gave this material effect, you get what I'm saying? And another thing, what's mean of Nawti, N-A-W-T-I? According to the video, it means natural African woman, totally inspiring. Now, according to his interview, he was basically trying to show the beauty and sex appeal of African women, right? Yeah, okay. So what was this chick doing in the video? I expect to see girls in braids, girls in ashoki, and all that, girls with tribal marks and stuff like that. Are you serious? Ashoki? Tribal marks? You're a dead guy, I swear. Okay, sorry for that rude interruption by that idiot, that no it all idiot. Anyways, as I was saying, okay, maybe I got a little bit carried away by the Ashoka and Chara Mark. What was I thinking? Anyways, at least maybe girls with braids, something representative of Africa, you get. Like the mistake everybody thought they were from Yankee. Then nobody knew that they were actually some Nigerian girls there. Now, for the issue of the kiss, I'm not going to say anything much about the kiss, but one person wasn't feeling that kiss there. Let me play the video for you so you guys see what I'm talking about. Let me play slow mo so you see where. Look closely. See them, they are looking. There was nothing really wrong with the kiss. It wasn't the best kiss ever, but it was just okay. It was just there. Then from timeline 227 continuously was just... That's a very clear example of telling a story in a music video without trying too hard to do so. Like when the mom catches her daughter in the same party and the mom even sees her friend and all that. She get. By the way, who does lose makeup? The girl doing her makeup should tone the lip gloss down a bit. She should reduce it. His lips were shining too much. It was blinding me when I was watching the video. You know, makes sense as they watch Olu dancing from their computer instead of watching themselves dancing. Did not make sense. Okay, that's basically everything about the video. Hope you enjoyed this review. My name is Olisa and you've just been angelified. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Do not forget to like me on Facebook. And most importantly, do not forget to molest that like button. Molest it. Share me on Facebook and do everything you can to make this video popular. Thank you. Nawti, baby, Nawti.